بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد beloved brothers and sisters in Islam respected علماء حفاظ and youth السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته Our beloved Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم states in a hadith which I mentioned in the khutbah on Friday من يريد الله به خيرا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ That when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes good for a person, He grants the person the fiqh of the deen, the understanding of the religion, which is in reality the literal meaning of the word fiqh. So when we study fiqh, walhamdulillah, know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the objective for you to gain a deeper understanding of the practices within which we engage, inshaAllah. Beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, very briefly this evening, we are still in the chapter of Tahara, the chapter of purification. And we are looking at, as the author states in this section, وَفُرُوضُ الْوُضُوءُ سِتَّةُ أَشْيَاءُ And the fard, the compulsory acts of the wudu, of your ablution, are six. So inshallah, as we go through the six, it's very important that we pay attention to what is, and we learned this many, many moons ago, many of us, alhamdulillah, but it is critical that you understand that the fard included in the wudu gets meticulous attention. You have to really pay attention to the ablution, the wudu, and these six body parts or these six areas, inshallah. So the first one, an-niyya, inda ghusl al-wajh. That the niyyah, the intention must be made, and as the author indicates, عِنْدَ غَسْلِ الْوَجْهِ By the time you wash your face. So the niyyah must be made by that particular time, right? And of course there are sunnah actions which precede it, which we will do in the future inshallah, but the niyyah must be made by then. وَغَسْلُ الْوَجْهِ And the washing of your face, is fard, وَغَسْلُ الْيَدَيْنِ إِلَى الْمِرْفَقَيْنِ And the washing of your hands to the elbows, and I'm going to touch on a fifth point very shortly, وَمَسْحُ بَعْضِ الرَّأْسِ And then the wiping of part of your head. Part of your head. Now note, as the author indicates, the verb changed. It went from غَسْل, washing, to مَسْح, to wiping. Which means there's a difference in the way we purify that particular body part. وَغَسْلُ رِجْلَيْنِ إِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ And the washing of your feet until, or rather to the ankles. وَالتَّرْتِيبُ عَلَى مَا ذَكَرْنَا And the last point, the sixth point, which is fard, particularly in the Shafi'i madhab, is the tartib, the order. So the author indicates what are the six areas of wudu that are fard, which emanates from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. So if you ever wondered, where does this come from? It is from Allah, in which Allah states in the Quran, Surah Ma'idah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا قُمْتُمْ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ فَاغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقِ وَامْسَحُوا بِرُؤُوسِكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ إِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ So here in the Quran, Allah specifically mentions which parts of your body have to be washed, and Allah gives the tartib. So Imam Ash-Shafi'i rahimahullah inherited the tartib of washing from the Quran, and hence tartib in the Shafi'i madhab is fard. So to keep these parts washed and of course conducted, the wudu conducted in its order is fard. In the Shafi'i madhab. I want to touch on a particular, on two issues here, inshallah, two gems, because we are talking about the fard, the compulsory acts of wudu. The first is that when it comes to washing the hands, or rather the hands and forearms, and washing the feet, it is critical, particularly according to the Shafi'i jurists, the fuqaha, that your elbows and your ankles are included in that which is washed. So it is a point of debate in fiqh. And the scholars differ, you know, in terms of the verb ila, which literally means to. Do we wash up until that point, or do we go past the point? So the elbows is usually a dangerous area, because when we are hastening wudu, we sometimes are a bit negligent and we don't check if we actually go past the elbow. So this is a critical point in accordance with the teachings in the Shafi'i Madhab in particular. When you wash your hands, forearms, it includes the washing of the elbow, that the scholars agree upon, that you need to ensure that your elbow, so a good check after you've completed wudu, just to see, you know, we're doing it for so many years already. When you are done, just check if there's dryness, because sometimes we go through it because it's subconsciously, you know, part of our daily routine. Check if there's a dryness, and then you'd know if you need to perfect and pay attention to that particular part of your body. And the same applies, you know, to your feet, your ankles. When we say ilal ka'bain, to the ankles, we are saying the ankles are included in that. So inshallah, that is an important gem. And then the last gem that we will close on this evening, inshallah, is the wiping of the head. So as the author indicates, وَمَسْحُ بَعْضِ الرَّأْسِ. So ba'd in Arabic, as we know, refers to a portion of. And often the lughawiyin, the linguists, they say that ba'd, you know, they even a portion to the word ba'd, that it might be a third. And some would say ba'd refers to a half. So you can imagine how ulama differ, you know, those specializing in language, taking on those specializing in fiqh on the word ba'd. So the Shafi'i scholars, majority of them indicate that it needs to be a portion. So some have said, and I've come across this teaching quite often, people say a minimum of 3 hairs. Now, probably on a technicality, there could be some merit to that opinion, but it would be best if we go into the teachings and the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We naturally find that a portion of the front part of the head of the Prophet ﷺ was, of course, wiped over. So it isn't an actual washing, meaning that, you know, like you would wash your hair normally. That is not required, but a wiping. And we recommend, you know, you'd be safe if you take a third of the head. Then there's generally no debate over there. And many have also asked which part of the head. Some, if they are wearing, you know, headgear, they want to use the back of the head. There isn't in any particular sort of like karaha, anything disliked on the portion, but preference is given, because we find this from the teachings of the Prophet ﷺ, preference is given to the hair at the front, your fringe area. So it would be best for you to rather take your taqiya, your kufya, your topi, or if it's your scarf, to move it back and to wipe over the front. And then that would meet the minimum requirement for mashu ras, mashu ba'd ras, the wiping of the portion of the head. Jazakallahu khairan wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam alayhi wa alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.